Rain barrels are a great way to collect stormwater runoff from your roof and conserve the water to use at a later time to water your landscaping or garden, usually during a dry spell. Rain barrels are connected directly to your downspout to collect the stormwater runoff. Installing a rain barrel yourself is easy, especially using these video instructions. The first step is to determine a location. Determine which downspout is ideal for connecting your rain barrel. When selecting a downspout, you may want to consider the following. Your rain barrel should be fairly close to the sites you want to water. Make sure your barrel does not impede any access to doors, paths, or equipment, such as air conditioning units. Also, ensure it is not in a main traffic path. And consider where your rain barrel will overflow. You can attach it to a second barrel or hook up a soaker hose. The second step is to select a diverter. There are a number of different types of diverters that are available. There is a standard diverter that is sold locally by the City of Lafayette. A Save the Rain metal diverter, which is available online. Or you can use a flexible downspout extension or a rigid downspout elbow with an extension, and these are available at your local hardware store. The type of diverter is usually determined by personal choice, but if you have limited options for placement of your rain barrel, for example, if you cannot get your rain barrel right next to the downspout, you may need the flexible extension or the standard diverter. Step 3, you will need to collect your tools. For this installation, you'll need a rain barrel diverter, a hacksaw, a straight edge, a T-square works great for this, a marker, a pair of tin snips, and a screwdriver. Make sure you have a screwdriver that matches the screws so you can unscrew the wraps or braces which currently attach your downspout to your house. The fourth step is to construct or purchase a base and make sure the base of your rain barrel is nice and level. Prepare the location of your rain barrel by clearing any debris from the area where your base will stand. You will want to construct or purchase a base for your rain barrel and ensure that the base is level and elevated. The bottom of the rain barrel should be elevated at least slightly higher than your watering site, since you will be reliant on gravity to pressurize any hoses you attach to your rain barrel. This also provides space to fill a watering can from your rain barrel. There are different ways to stabilize and elevate your rain barrel, including using a stand made of pressure-treated wood or using bricks or cement blocks. Use gravel as a base for leveling if using bricks or cement blocks. Regardless of the type of stand, create a stable, flat, level surface on which your rain barrel will be placed. Check this using a level. Remember that 55 gallons of water weighs almost 500 pounds, so it is important that the rain barrel be stable. Place your stand on the stable surface you created for your rain barrel. Place the rain barrel on the stand. For the fifth step, mark your downspout. Using your straight edge, draw a line on your downspout where your diverter shall be installed. Where to mark your downspout will be determined by which diverter you have chosen. Use the T-square to ensure your line is parallel with the ground. If you are installing the standard diverter, spin the rain barrel until the black capped connector is next to the downspout. Then hold your straight edge level with the black cap on the barrel and use it to draw a line on the downspout. It is very important that your straight edge and your mark is level. If your mark is lower than the black capped connector, your rain barrel will not fill because the water will not flow uphill. If your mark is higher than the black capped connector, your rain barrel will continue to fill even when it is full. This is why it's important to have a plan for overflow to another rain barrel or to a hose. If the mark is correct, when the rain barrel is full, the water will be diverted down the downspout. If you are using the Save the Rain metal diverter, use a straight edge to draw a line approximately 9 inches above the top of your rain barrel. Make sure your rain barrel is on the stand before measuring. If you are using flexible or rigid downspouts, the discharge end should be within 1/2 inch of the top of the rain barrel to reduce splash. Line up the downspout and mark. Remember that the two pieces overlap, so account for that space. Remove the barrel from the stand and move both it and the stand temporarily out of the way. The sixth step is to detach the lower portion of the downspout from the house. Your downspout may be attached to the house with an aluminum wrap or brace. Unscrew the wrap from the lower portion of the downspout below where you marked your line, but leave the wrap attached to the house. Place the screws in a safe location as you will need these again later. The seventh step is to cut the downspout. Using your hacksaw, cut along the line you drew on the downspout. You may want to slip a piece of cardboard behind the downspout to protect your house while you cut. Set aside the bottom portion of your downspout so that it's still within reach. You will reattach this piece if you are using the standard diverter or the Save the Rain metal diverter. If using a flexible or rigid downspout, keep this piece and reinstall for winterization. If you are installing the standard diverter, you will need to snip triangles out of the top portion of the downspout. Using your tin snips on the top portion of the downspout, cut a small triangle measuring approximately 1 inch high out of the side of the downspout, not the front. Repeat this on both sides of the downspout and discard the cutout triangles. Install a clip, brace, or strap above where the diverter will be placed, approximately 4 to 6 inches. The eighth step is to fit the diverter to the downspout. If you are using the standard diverter, orient your diverter so that the hose points towards where the rain barrel will be installed. Fit the diverter into the downspout. The downspout should fit snugly over the round PVC pipe in the diverter. Connect the bottom portion of the downspout to the diverter by bringing back the bottom portion of the downspout that you had previously set aside. Then fit it over the round PVC pipe on the bottom of the diverter. If you are using the Save the Rain metal diverter, place the metal diverter over the top portion of the downspout, the part that is still connected to the house. Connect the bottom portion of the downspout into the bottom of the diverter. You may need to crimp the sides of the downspouts to ensure the diverter fits correctly. If you are using flexible or rigid downspouts, slip either the rigid elbow or flexible downspout over the top portion of the downspout, the part that is still connected to the house. If you are using a rigid elbow, place the rigid extension on the end of the elbow. Secure the elbow to the downspout using small screws. If you used a rigid extension, you will want to also secure the extension to the elbow. The ninth step is to reattach the bottom portion of the downspout to the house. This is only if you are using a standard diverter or the Save the Rain metal diverter. Fit the downspout into the clip, brace, or strap, and replace the screws so that the downspout is once again attached to the house and the diverter is held firmly in place. The tenth step is to complete the rain barrel installation. Replace the stand and place the rain barrel on the stand. If you are using a standard diverter, spin the rain barrel so that the black capped connector, the one you use to mark your downspout, is oriented close to the diverter. Unscrew the black cap from the rain barrel and screw the diverter hose onto the rain barrel. Save the black cap as you will reattach this to the diverter hose when you winterize your barrel. If you are using the Save the Rain metal diverter, set the angle of the diverter so that the water will flow into the top of the rain barrel. If you are using a flexible or rigid downspout, extend it or place the rigid extension so that the end of the downspout is within 1/2 inch of the top of the rain barrel to minimize splash. The final step is to winterize your rain barrel. Disconnect and winterize your rain barrel to prevent any damage to the rain barrel and downspout. Drain your rain barrel using the last bit of stored water for your landscaping or garden. The best time to winterize your rain barrel is on or around the first annual frost. If you are using a standard diverter, remove the hose from the diverter and install the black cap that you had saved. Leave the hose attached to your rain barrel. If you are using the Save the Rain metal diverter, flip the diverter up to close the downspout. If you are using a flexible or rigid downspout, reinstall the bottom portion of the downspout you saved. If you used a rigid downspout for water delivery to your rain barrel, remove the rigid pieces and replace them with a flexible downspout. Secure the flexible downspout to the top portion of the downspout still connected to the house. Cut 4 to 6 inches off the bottom portion of the downspout you had saved. You may need to also add a clip, brace, or strap to the house near the top of the bottom piece of the downspout. Stretch the flexible downspout until it connects with the lower portion of the downspout. Once your rain barrel is disconnected, you can either flip the barrel upside down and place a weight on top of it, preventing it from being blown over, or you can move the barrel into a garage or shed for the winter.